going to be a generic wayfinding program that is a template of wayfinding that could be used in any commercial neighborhood in the city. And then it will be an actual bricks and mortar, an actual installation of wayfinding signs that will start downtown because it's being funded out of our parking program. And the program does, Mark may cut this slightly different, program's focused on sort of, at least the way I look at it, three different things. One is, or maybe four different things. One is helping people find where parking spots are. That's the reason it's being paid for out of the parking study that came out of a parking consultant process. We know people spend a lot, particularly visitors, out-of-towners, spend a lot of time cruising around downtown looking for parking spots, and to the extent we can direct them in the right direction to underutilized parking lots, that would be great. So that's one goal. The second goal is to help us create sort of a sense of arrival for downtown Northampton. We're beginning to put gateway signs up at the edge of downtown. We put the first one up by Lamprin Park. We're looking at doing art sculptures and some of the new roundabouts that are coming to town. But we don't really have a great sense of arrival when you get into downtown itself. And so this helps sort of create the sense of place that's here. That's why the branding, the sense of what we're talking about is so important. The third, and this is particularly for visitors, though to some extent for Northampton residents, is just an orientation. If you get downtown and want to figure out where I'm going, you know, we want to help people figure out where the different spots are. And related to that, we know lots of our visitors drive to Northampton, which we're fine with, but we want them to drive once and then park and walk to all the destinations. And we know that sometimes people think the distances are greater than they really are. So someone coming to the Roundhouse parking lot here and eating on this side of town and then going to an event on the Arts Trust on Holly Street, they might think, oh, I should just drive there. And we want to send the message, no, this is a really short distance and people can walk once they get there. And then the final component is we have a lot of sandwich board signs downtown. Sandwich board signs are really important for commercial businesses who aren't on the first floor on Main Street, but they eat up a lot of real estate. They make it really hard to clear the snow from Main Street. When we have a windy day, sometimes they blow over. And so one of the charges, think about how can we replace those sandwich board signs, still give visibility to merchants, but something that's not at the ground level, that's on a post of some kind. To that end, we did an RFP for skilled wayfinding consultants, reached out to sort of all the, what seemed like the most skilled wayfinding firms in the state, and Faverman Design submitted the winning bid. And so Mark's going to give sort of a 20-minute, and we'll kick him if he takes more than 20 minutes, 20-minute quick overview as to what this is all about. And then the rest of the night is we want to hear from you, and Mark's going to lead you through a workshop. So
advances. Right here?
Yeah, one of the right advances.
Okay. Yeah. Good evening, everybody. Thank you for coming. It's interesting what we are about. We're actually about two things. One is deciding what the character of Northampton is so that we can somehow express that in the elements that we use for wayfinding. And the other is comfort, which is what signage gives you. If you find ease of access and ease of getting from one place to the other. So those are the two things that we're about. Now, I'm going to go through quickly a number of things, and then we'll get to the workshop part, and that's going to be interactive. So therefore, you're going to have to express yourselves, and I'm going to stop talking, which is going to be hard for me, but I'll do it. Anyway, let's not. So community branding is the application of large-scale branding to civic environments, corporate entities, sports events, and institutions. If any of you have been to Paris, it's not the Eiffel Tower, it's the metro, or the subway stops that are quite beautiful, Art Nouveau, and they underscore what Paris is about, the elegance of it. Hopefully we can come up with something, but maybe not as grand as that. Other subway systems have developed. Even our much maligned T has a look to it. What it's about, community branding, is reinforcement of identity, visually defining character, underscoring uniqueness, linking collective memory, and connecting communal familiarity. So it's about making community in a very visual way. And from that, we get a sense of arrival, as Wayne was saying, a sense of place when we've arrived there, a sense of shared visual memory, and then community ethos, which underscores this experience. Three dimensions of branding. There's brand image, which is reputation, what people say about you, or what you say about yourselves. Brand identity, which is a core concept of the community. And brand behavior, which is branding applied. The power of community brand. By the way, I don't know if you noticed, but that's the Minuteman that's in Lexington, right? And this is motif number one in Rockport. Everybody paints it, the red barn there. The power of community brand is to celebrate attributes and assets. It underscores positive perceptions. It supports economic stimulation, very important, and strengthens pride of place. And community branding includes the following: cultural narrative, urban engagement, small-scale interventions, communal experience, focused perception, place promotion, stakeholder ownership, and strategic visions. This picture is under a gateway sculpture that I created in 2007 in Boston, and this is a mile and a quarter from the finish line of the Boston Marathon. And this is at Audubon Circle, so there are birds at Audubon Circle. A few case studies that I wanted to show you, just so you get an idea of something that we can come up with. For the town of, if it'll do it, the town of Winchester, it's not staying, huh? I'll get it. The town of Winchester, hello, we did a whole project that was site specific. So this, the town hall, the library, parks, schools, all had specific signs. And now we're adding directional signs to that. For Peabody, the city of Peabody, we developed a slogan with the community, and they came up with live for Peabody and live in the terms of the community for Peabody. They're losing younger people. They want people to know that it's going to be a very livable and alive place. And then some of the hardware details come from symbolic hardware that we find in other places within the community, and we'll talk about that in a minute. So where is Northampton? Northampton is where you enter, and you see this sign. But in regard to the state, it's Hampshire County. It's centrally located there. It is a historical community, as you can see by this map and this map. But it is a very almost square type of environment, and you can enter it from different directions, and you may not know you're entering it or feel that you've entered it, and we're going to try to fix that. It's also part of the Pioneer Valley. It is the seat of Hampshire County, and it's a knowledge, part of the knowledge corridor, so it has those aspects to it. Now, easier, what is Northampton? Now, you all can do that in a few words, right, what Northampton is. I don't know if you can. This is just a series of shots of streetscapes and buildings and structures, just to give you sort of a feel for what we're going to get into when we start to describe it. This is an interesting slide because it shows street hardware, a bicycle rack, a sculpture, a memorial to people who were involved in retail in the community, and then a ubiquitous parking toll-taking machine, right? Speaking of parking, you have color-coded parking meters. You may or may not know this, but 30% of all men are colorblind. Women give it to us, so they share in our problem. And so a lot of, just about a third of men would not know the difference of most colors. So you have to be very careful what you use. Just an aside there. There's a scale issue in Northampton, which is quite wonderful. In an urban design sense, we refer to the buildings and the streets here as good bones. Northampton has great bones as a community. If you look at this picture, you see the parking garage, which is very important, is way down the hill. And you really, and it's a one-way street going the wrong way. So you really have to think about how you're going to get there. So we're going to try to help with that problem down the road. Wonderful structures. The one on the right used to be kind of purple, I think, at one point. And it's now gray. Or do I have that wrong? I think it was. When the Ninja Turtles had a museum there, right? Here's the new Amtrak station. Your music center. Here are two very strong music venues. Side street, that's quite part of, is actually part of the access to the community. A bridge that has a graphic narrative on it, talking visually to what's going on. An old fire station that is now the Starwood Cafe? Yeah? I want to say Woodstar, but Starwood, yeah. Woodstar, yeah. Very historic buildings in town as well. Interesting juxtaposition of town hall or city hall and retail areas. Public art from the contemporary to the classical. Serious museum, museum murals that have a museum quality in terms of talking about a history, a timeline. Other details, smaller murals and a tree grate that is clearly a decorative tree grate, which adds, again, character. Other buildings, street furniture that has character, both painted and a contemporary sculptural form. Institutions that have impact on the community. The two biggest, I think, are Smith College and Cooley Dickinson Healthcare. See Smith. The new park, Pulaski Park. And I saw this behind a building across from that large mural, and I thought this is very interesting that somebody was actually creating sort of a wonderful planted area temporarily in the back. There's a lot of nice planting on Main Street, by the way. So that leads us to the exercise. I have some things that we can write on. Do we have easels that we can put them? Okay, behind that bench in the back are the three pads. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to ask you in a series of questions that I will pose to give word ideation, that is, give us a word description, and the first word that comes to your mind, and we're going to see how we can get several of them out, and the word will somehow, in a positive way, they all have to be positive, a positive way, what Northampton is. And so that's how we start. Wayne went to get some easels, and we will put the pads up. And I need a volunteer who can write very well. Is there a former teacher here? Is there a former school teacher who can write nicely? Somebody is. No? Somebody has to volunteer to write. Because I'm left-handed, and I can't write very well on a board.
I can do it.
You can do it. Okay, good. If we can you go in the right where that bench is, where those lovely people are sitting? Can you pull out those pads, the three pads there? That'd be very helpful. Behind them, they're in a bag. So this is a process that I learned about 20 years ago when I was working on the 1996 Atlanta Olympics, and they had a number of design firms working together, and they were trying to get us to agree on things. So what we had to do is develop ways to create uniformity or uniformity of thought. Now, you can write?
Yep.
Okay. We can start. I think we can do just start this one. You can get it to stand up.
Okay.
And I have a pen for you. I know, but to keep things moving, we can start, and then he can, we're going to use several easels when we finish. How are these? See if they work. Put one word at the top. So this is, I'm going to start you all off with one word. And it could be an adjective. You stand it up, yeah, so they can see. Right. Okay? Oh, here it comes. Great. So it's very quick. We're getting ready to start without you.
Go ahead.
Okay, one word description. Anybody? How would you describe Northampton? One word. Yes, sir.
Home.
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 Okay. Now, let me suggest something. You want it to be what's unique about Northampton as well. Home, we can work that in somehow, but that's fine. Another one in the back.
Yes. Vibrant.
Vibrant. Okay. Yes.
Diverse.
Diverse. Yes.
Historic.
Other words?
Can everyone see that? Does it need to be bigger?
Okay.
Wonderful.
That's why she was chosen.
Not really.
But where are my green and organic words?
Oh, that's nice.
Green, organic.
Green, organic, right? Green, organic, two words. Any other ones?
Sustaining,
progressive, another one. You're getting into it now. This is good.
Hardy.
Hardy.
Art.
Arty.
Art. Art.
Arty. Arty.
Artistic.
I like Hardy too.
Hold on, we're gonna take a break for a minute.
Okay. Oh, I said fun.
Fun. Sorry. Fun.
Delicious.
Can you see that?
We can now, thank you. Thank you for
everyone see this.
Anything else?
Hardworking.
That's two words with a hyphen. Wait. We'll get to two words in a minute.
Tasty.
Tasty. What kind of institution is Smith? Academic?
Smart.
All right, smart is another good word, yeah. We have progressive, right?
Progressive, yes.
Any other word like that anybody wants to suggest?
Ambitious.
Ambitious, good word.
Welcoming.
Another good word. This is the first time you've been allowed to just shout out anything, and it's all good.
Mind-bending.
Two words.
Green.
Yeah, we have green. Green / organic.
Walkable.
Any other one word?
Friendly.
Okay. Any others? Yes.
Quirky.
Bikeable. Now, being from the East.
I heard somebody whisper a great one, edgy.
That's a good one.
Being from the eastern part of the state, we have another descriptive word for funky. I don't know if you accept that, but that's one of the words to describe. You can put it there. We're going to get rid of some of these too, as part of the exercise. Okay. Any more one-word descriptive terms? Okay. Let's go to the next one and two words, so we can do a mind-bending and some of those other words that you were saying.
Sorry. Two words?
Two words.
Gender inclusive. Okay. I said gender inclusive.
How about musical venue? How about, from what I see, independent retail? Mm-hmm. Not a lot of chain stores, right? Mm-hmm.
Local business.
Because that may be even better one than what I said.
Saturday market.
I'm sorry?
Saturday market.
I just saw a Tuesday market. Huh?
Tuesday market, what the heck?
Tuesday market too.
Thriving street light.
Gay pride.
Street lights one more.
Any other two word phrases? Okay.
I think I spelled entrepreneur wrong.
We'll correct that. All will be corrected soon. Third one. Now this will give you a lot more freedom to express yourselves. This is three words or more. Three words or more to describe Northampton.
Hamp and Noho.
Ham and Noho.
Ham and Noho.
Am and Noho. I haven't heard anything with future in it. Any phrase about future? A unique downtown.
Terry, where are you?
Excuse me.
Open for business.
Nice.
Night out.
Anything in terms of town and gown?
More than a college town.
An incubator and an inspiration.
Historic sightseeing.
Beautifully preserved wilderness.
Yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
Anybody say anything about it being a safe environment? So what about a safe, open environment? Does that sound right?
That's to be taken for granted, right?
Well.
Calvin Coolidge home.
You can just peel that off and leave it on.
From canal boats to bicycles.
Did you say canal?
Canal.
Any more? We can come back to. Anything poetic? Like four seasons of something. Okay.
Too late to add to the two words.
Oh, we're going to come back.
Bike path? Yeah.
And we can put that there. We can get to that.
High quality library. A city on the river.
Any more? At this point, no, we'll come back to these in a few minutes. Next one is, how would you, if you were thinking of colors, what colors would you have for Northampton? Why blue and gold?
That's the high school.
That's the high school colors, okay. Any other colors?
Blue.
hard one now. How would we express Northampton in terms of symbols? What's a symbol that suggests Northampton?
Bicycle. Mills.
Leaves.
Six leaves.
Leaves.
Oh, leaves.
The Gothic towers on the city hall. Trees.
Sojourn of Truth image.
I'm sorry?
Sojourn of Truth image.
And David Rebels.
David Rebels?
R-U-G-G-L-E-S. Underground Railroad.
What do we have? Farm animals?
Farm animals and chickens, yeah. Rainbow flag.
People strolling or walking or running or exercise. People moving.
See that a lot.
Maybe the oxbow?
As in being an outsider, when I think of Northampton, I think of the downtown and the streetscape. Maybe that's another one if you agree. But the streetscape of the buildings, I think, is very important. Spires. Any more?
There's the arc of the river as you look at it. Aerial, you know. Mm-hmm. And also the Holyoke Range has a distinctive.
The Holyoke Mountains?
Range.
Range. Are they hill? I was going to say, are they hills or mountains? Or
range.
Wrong.
Neither.
Any more? These are good.
Bears.
Bears.
Like E-A-R?
E-A-R.
Any others? Okay. Any others? So the next question may be hard to answer, but maybe it's not. What would you like Northampton to be in the future? Say that again, please.
Vibrant and the best city all around.
You got that?
Grandchildren's home.
That's an interesting concept.
Neighborly. A funky mix of the old and the new. Things that are conserved and things that are experimental.
Okay.
Funky mix of the old and the new, with the things that are conserved, like our green space and our farms and our open space and our wilderness and our historical places are conserved, and our small businesses are conserved, and our downtown distinctiveness is conserved, and then room for experimentation and innovation and new things and new ideas. Say four words there.
You can say whatever she wants.
Does that capture the spirit of what you were saying?
Growing.
Yeah. Leafy.
Fearless.
A heritage for the future.
Welcoming to refugees.
Just.
Anything else? Pretty good list. Now, here's a question for you. Should there be more public art in Northampton? Temporary? Permanent?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Okay. Well, you don't have to write anything, I think. We're going to have a discussion. I don't think we need to with that answer. Both. Other thoughts? Now, you can say anything you want at this point about it. And then we're going to go back through everything and see what were stronger and what were weaker, and we'll get rid of some of the phrases and emphasize them. And then I'm going to explain to you what we'll do with all this word ideation. Other thoughts? Anybody want to express something?
More frequent train service.
Affordable housing.
Historic signage.
What do you mean by that?
There are a whole series of important places here.
So information.
Including a hidden mill, a hidden river that ran through town. Just information.
Right. Wayfinding and signage in general, there are four components of it. One is identity, one is informational, another is directional, and the fourth one, which you don't have here except in parking areas, restrictive. So those are the four areas, so certainly that's an important part. And we also want to emphasize along the way trail signs as well. So there are quite a few components of what we're going to try to accomplish. And we will accomplish it over the next 10 months, I guess, to get there. Other thoughts?
Under other thoughts, I would hope that when you're almost there and you know what you want to do, you test it out on a few people who do not know the city well.
Good idea. So we'll put up temporary signs first, yeah.
See how they
can put temporary signs.
And the other thought, and I'm revealing my age here, street signs and whatnot need to be fairly large.
Right. Right.
Public restrooms.
Anything else? Yes.
It occurs to me that people read a sign, but they react to it in ways that they're not conscious of. A beautiful sign, you react one way. We have a sign on our parking garage that says, welcome to Northampton, where, what does it say? The coffee is strong and so are the women.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There are signages that we have that are quirky and give people a taste of what they're walking into. They've never been to such a precious, small, diverse, interesting, dynamic, quirky city. Our signages can help people feel a sense of belonging, or they can feel alienated, or they can feel in like it's impersonal, or they can feel like I've never been to a place like this before. And I would err on the side of what can we do to help people quickly figure out who we are and where they've arrived, because they're not in Kansas anymore.
And I'm not in Canvas, no.
I think I should write that book.
Not in Kansas anymore.
One way to focus that is to think through what you might want to put on the highway, on I-91. And I know there are a lot of restrictions and whatnot, but if you could put one sign up, you know, when it's time to go off to Northampton, what would you... Right now it's just a list of hotels and...
Things to do, yeah.
McDonald's and Burger King's and...
It doesn't encourage you to go to Northampton rather than someplace else.
You have any suggestions?
Probably. Yeah, some of this stuff.
What about though, phone apps and things like that? Because we just traveled across the country and just came back, and I got to tell you, by the way, Sioux Falls, South Dakota was fabulous. Art everywhere, all kinds of traffic, dieting, wonderful stuff. But when we were traveling and we were going on little highways, we were looking on the phone all the time to find the funky places and to find the stuff, and it wasn't signage that was leading us there.
Well, that's now part of signage, right? And I'll tell you a little story. We've been working for about a year and a half with the town of Ipswich. And Ipswich is a very interesting town because it has about 17,000 people in it. And 750,000 plus come every summer to Crane's Beach. And then they turn around and they go back. They don't go into the town. But Ipswich has 59 first construction houses that people still live in. That is, houses built between 1630 and 1725. So they want people to know about this historical, unique quality. No town in North America has this. And so we were trying to develop stuff for them, and they came up with a slogan because they have their biggest taxpayers today are high-tech industries and biotech. So they are calling Bridging History. So that's because they have a famous bridge there, and that's what we came up with. The second phase was to do kiosks. And thinking they're a historical town, we did sort of a standard kiosk. And the people said, no, that's not what we want. And I said, well, what do you want? And they said, we want a video kiosk that we can control from the town hall and that can change and has a TV screen and works all year round. So, thinking futuristically, you can do signage that are apps, which are part of the system. So social media is definitely part of the system, and in a kiosk that is highly advanced technically. And when we started talking about the kiosk 2 years ago, I said the price is going to come down, and sure enough, it's gotten to the point that it's much more cost efficient. So all of these new technologies have to be looked at as well. So it's a good point you made. That's a very good point.
With good maps, and that's how all the young people are doing it. We should have a virtual walking map. You could even do some Pokemon things that come in and out, a lot more, because that's what people are, you know, that kind of image. But that's the
I remember what our parents used, and some of us used. AAA maps, and they...
Oh, gotcha. Yeah, but nobody does that anymore.
No, but they worked. They worked, though, in the past, so it's interesting, old and new technology together.
Well, even old people are using it, though.
Right? Right. Any more, or any other thoughts?
Community policing, good community policing.
Okay. You want to expound on that? Or?
It just feels comfortable. I mean, good cops, no bad cops. There's a kind of sense that it's okay. Something bad might happen, but
And you're describing the present tense, right?
Especially because there are a lot of street people too, but the cops and the street people talk to each other all the time. There's a sense of maybe it's part of security.
Well, I said earlier that I thought I feel a safe environment here, and I thought that we have. So let's go back over. Thank you. I need you to move over there. No. I don't know if they'd be able to see a difference of the green. And take one of the blacks here. Okay. Okay, so let's look at the one words first.
You can
do it from there. You can do it, because I'll repeat them, and let's go over the one word. Okay, home, vibrant, diverse, historic, green, organic. There's one word each. Progressive, artistic, fun, tasty, academic, smart, ambitious, welcoming, walkable, friendly, funky, quirky, bikeable, edgy. Okay. So let's look at these words and see which ones we want to keep and which ones we don't want to keep.
I'd suggest a general principle, and that is that any word that most towns would claim
right.
should go.
Yes, I agree. But we'll get to that, I mean, hopefully as we do this. All right, so home, do we want to keep that?
Mm-hmm.
We do, okay.
Check mark?
You don't have to do anything to it. Vibrant. We also dynamic was used earlier too. Is vibrant or dynamic a better word?
Vibrant.
Okay, so write out dynamic and put a line through it. Okay, diverse.
Yes.
You feel it's really a diverse town?
No.
No. Take that one out.
Oh, wait a minute. I mean, I think there'd be some disagreement there. It certainly aspires to be diverse.
That's true.
Yeah, but that's aspirational. I'm talking about what it is today.
I just moved into town, and of course, it depends where.
Did you add to the diversity here by you moving in?
I would argue for keeping the word in.
Yeah, maybe a show of hands as opposed to just individuals.
Yeah.
Maybe it should be moved to future.
What is that?
We're at 85% non-Hispanic white.
What about gay, lesbian, Africa?
That I don't have good numbers on. I don't know.
I would have thought it's pretty good.
It is.
When I think of the word diversity in Northampton, I admit it's not by race diverse. But I think what people respond to is the number of tattoos and purple hair and people who look different than mm-hmm. what they've ever seen
right.
before. When they come here, they're like, whoa, you can see anything on the streets of Northampton. Or so the vibe is. And
is
so
it,
that's where diverse comes from.
Is it diversity or tolerance?
People are doing that all over the place now. That's
yeah.
not so unique.
Not
you know, not really. It's that way in every college now.
But is the question diversity or is it tolerance?
Well, is this supposed to be what we are today or what we aspire to be?
Well, the future question was aspirational, so we can move that to the future, diverse, or we can leave it.
Well, it's what people don't know that are coming in to see us, then what are they,
you know, what do they read into that? I mean, what if you didn't live here,
that's right,
what would you think diverse meant?
It ain't Brooklyn.
Should we move on to some other word and see what else we come up with that's even better?
Put a star by diverse. How's that?
Interesting that we're stuck on that one.
Inclusive.
Inclusive may be a much better word.
Yeah.
Inclusive, I think, is a much better word than diverse. And I think that really states what Northampton's about, and is more descriptive. So let's take the star off of diverse and let's circle inclusive. Good. All right. Historic, green, organic.
Don't need those.
No.
Which better?
Green.
Okay. Is sustainable up there as well?
No.
Okay. Usually that's up there too. And
shall I add it?
Sure. Progressive. Is that a good word?
Yeah.
Artistic.
Yes.
Is artistic the word or is creative a better word? I'm asking you. I'm not saying what it is.
There's a lot of art.
Okay.
Artists.
Yeah.
But creativity is not the issue. It's art. Okay. Fun, is that a good word or not?
No.
How many people say keep fun? Okay, take the fun out of
here. Take the fun out of
it. How about tasty?
Yeah.
I think that goes too, right? Academic?
It's not really.
Right. Okay. Smart.
Yeah.
Why did we cross off academic?
Because there was a group that said not really. Well, let's see. How many say keep academic? Raise their hand. Keep it. I just want to give you a parallel. One of our clients is called Wellesley. And Wellesley College is right in Wellesley. And they have that issue too. There's also Babson College. They have three, I think, Olin and Babson and Wellesley.
How about the word collegiate?
Collegiate. Now that means...
I don't think it's any better.
No. So I'm just saying that the other communities wrestle with this. This is not a...
Seems like with Amherst so close.
Yeah, and Amherst has three. Yeah, they have three. Yeah, there.
How many laboratories here? Smith.
But you're right. Smith is a major shadow on the community, for good or bad. It's a major shadow that you know it has true impact. So.
When I think of Smith students and Northampton and walking from campus into downtown and then off of downtown and onto the bike trail and into the wilderness and to farms and stuff, my dream is that those students are being shaped by their experience while they're living here for 4 years and are going out into the world and recreating what's special about Northampton for the rest of the world. And that's my dream. But the more dynamic, vibrant, experimental, and traditional, and you know, the more we have in the mix that's happening in Northampton, that it is way beyond what college student life is about, the more we touch young adult lives and the more they're going to
work to solve the world's problems based on what they experienced here.
Expanding on what you're saying, because of the five college, what's the word, coalition or whatever it's called, a lot of students from the other schools come here too.
Here.
Right. Yeah, due to shuttles and things. So that it's not just Smith, but it's other universities.
Here for the restaurants and the music and the hangout spots. And
that ain't academic.
But it's a community of colleges.
That's true.
Well, SMART can be used in a number of ways. SMART can mean academic, but SMART can be that you're a smart dresser or you're a smart.
Okay, so let's go back to academic. How many people want academic? Raise their hand. One. How many want smart?
Knowledge.
Knowledge, yeah. We're in the knowledge corridor.
Right.
Knowledge.
That's two words. Go to the two-word one. Knowledge corridor.
How about informed?
That's a good word. Informed. So take out academic and smart and put it in, that's replaced by informed. Is that okay? Informed? How about intellectual community on the two words? See, what's fun about this is as you're explaining it, phrases start coming out and other expressions. Okay, we do have sustainable there. We had green, organic, and now sustainable. What's better, green or sustainable? Okay.
But you see, you were going after, people were thinking about what the place looked like. They were going after green because of the trees and all of that.
Okay.
Which is a different kind of green than the organic or sustainable or whatever. I think those are.
But don't you like the fact that the word can have different meanings, yeah, and different layers? Whereas sustainable, define that for me.
Sustainable suggests that people proactively care about those issues. Green, as you suggest, suggests more lots of trees
and advertising,
all of that.
Sustainable means that you're not using certain energies or implies that you've reached a certain level when you're sustainable. Are we sustainable or are we green? Are we trying to get greener? Are we trying to use better electricity? Are we trying to compost? Are we trying to recycle our bottles? I think of that as green. And sustainable as some place where you're not using as much electricity. We have much more solar or wind or.
I think sustainable also has a broader net and can reach into economic sustainability and community sustainability as well as ecological and environmental issues. So that when we talk about the survival of small businesses, the affordability of housing, workers earning enough to live in the community, I think sustainable captures all of that as well.
Broad policies that sustain life in community.
Sustainable is a good word, is what I'm hearing. Is green as good a word?
It's a different
word. It's different. Keep them both.
Okay. But if you use them next to each other, it's confusing. I'm just.
Don't use them next to each other.
Okay. Ambitious, is that a word that rings true?
No.
Okay. Welcoming, is this true?
Yes.
Okay. Walkable?
Yeah.
Welcoming and friendly, are they similar? Different? This is a New England community, so friendly is not necessarily New England.
Welcome to Northampton.
But welcoming is still a nice term. I think one of them should go. I'm not going to say which, but...
Having just moved into town, I would keep both, because I'm impressed by both.
Okay.
They are different. Welcoming is more, you know, your neighbors coming over and not being angry that somebody sold the house and somebody new is coming in. Friendly is more general. And as I go in, you know, nobody knows who I am, I go...
But welcoming also means... Could also mean accepting strangers,
yeah,
and not necessarily rejecting them. Mm-hmm. That doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to be friendly with them.
No, but I'm finding, I mean, I'm just one person, I'm finding both.
Okay. Funky.
You suggested that.
No, I did, because it's how it's termed. But if it doesn't work for you, this is your town, right? Your city. Take it out. Quirky is not necessarily a positive term, right? It suggests...
It's one of our strengths.
So quirky is eccentric, right? But if you saw somewhere in a slogan, come to the welcoming, eccentric place, I'm not sure that that's good.
Right. Not like keep Portland weird?
Keep Portland weird?
Weird or strange, not better.
Too liable to be misunderstood.
All right, well, we'll leave it in for the time being. Bikeable, so it's walkable and bikeable.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's fine. Aims to be.
Aims to be, right.
Okay. Edgy.
No.
I think we can take that one out, right? Dynamic.
Yeah.
It's already got a line for it.
Yeah.
It's already got.
Well, because vibrant was the one that was chosen. So circle vibrant. It's the second one. And I think we need to circle artistic. So that seems to be a very positive one. Any other ones that are very strong? Sustainable, circle that one. That was one of our most sustained discussions. Sustainable. Okay. Anybody else want to make any comments about these words? Sure. Vibrant. Let's circle historic.
Yeah.
A progressive.
Circle.
Green. Green we wanted, right?
Circle.
Yeah. The green was one that was kept in. Artistic. Sustainable. Welcoming, circle that. Walkable. Friendly. Quirky. Likeable.
Quirky?
Oh, quirky. We took that one out. Sorry. I thought. And inclusive. And informed. Okay, so those are pretty good words, right? Anybody have any?
Oh, what about home?
Home? Do we want to keep home in?
No, anyone.
No.
Okay, it's not distinctive. Okay, let's go to the two words as quickly as we can. So gender inclusive.
Yeah.
homegrown. Does that have any meaning to anybody?
No.
Musical venue.
Should be plural.
Venues?
Okay. I'm thinking of the city as a venue by itself. It's where you would go to hear music.
Sounds like you're aiming at one, however, and there aren't many, so that's an
Okay. Hardworking. Is that different than a lot of places? No. I like this next one, but I'm not sure it helps. Wicked fun? Sounds like Salem. Left-leaning, I think we have a better one word, progressive, than left-leaning. I think progressive sounds better.
Yeah.
And I think it's really sort of the same meaning. Economically diverse, is that really different than a lot of places? I don't, and I'm not sure it's positive. Independent retail, and that was, I'm afraid to use this word here, trumped by local businesses. Local business. I like that here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So circle that one. Yeah. Entrepreneurial spirit. I think that's suggested by local businesses, right? The Saturday, Tuesday market thing, they're nice, but almost every community has a farmer's market or a market of some kind. So it's not that different, though it's very nice here. So I don't think that helps describe the community. Thriving street life. Now that is somewhat distinctive. I mean, you really have a street life. So anybody want to just talk about that anymore? So we should leave it, you think? Okay, circle that one. Gay pride. And that's different here than any other community? No. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, it's stronger here, you think? Okay. So circle that one. Knowledge corridor.
That's a term being used.
The region, right.
Yeah.
But I think we had a better word, informed was the word, one word that we had on the other one. I think that sort of says it too. If you're informed, you're knowledgeable, right?
I think they're trying to touch different things. I think some folks want the Smith College and our academics recognized versus informed. I think that's more the population being involved and informed, like we're all here right now, you know?
Okay.
And I think that we have to include the fact that it's not just Smith College that's providing education in this community. We have a lot of different schools, programs that are providing this on a much broader basis. So I truly feel that either the academics or knowledge itself be included and not shifted off to one
would
side.
Would intellectually alive do it?
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
What about scholarly? I don't know, is that?
No.
No.
Intellectually alive?
Well, we have an intellectual community, which we haven't gotten to yet. That's up there. So that you said earlier, but if you want to change it to intellectually alive, I think that's more vibrant. So take out knowledge corridor. And do we need bike paths, or that's not very specifically Northampton either?
Oh, it is.
No, it isn't. They're everywhere now.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, they're everywhere.
Well, Northampton's going to be an epicenter for a whole bunch of trails that are going to meet and stop, you know, like, whether you go to New Haven or to Boston, it's going to meet up right here in Northampton.
Bikeable would do it.
Bikeable, we have that circled, right? Bikeable?
Yes.
So you take out bike paths, I think, one over the other.
So I'm circling gender-inclusive musical venues.
Is there a better one than musical venues that someone has? Or is that all right?
Live entertainment.
That might be better. Live entertainment may be better than musical venues.
Entertaining.
Yeah, live entertainment. So we have, how many words are those on the bottom there? Two words?
No, these were the phrases, I think.
The what?
Phrases.
Oh, those are phrases. There are more phrases over here, though, right?
These were colors. This is what we
wanted. Well, those are phrases, too.
Yeah.
So we have three pages of phrases.
This is future.
Future, okay. Mark got future, then, so we don't get it confused.
Paying you for this.
And what is the one on the right? What are those over there?
Images.
Okay. Symbols and images. Good. Okay, so let's do phrases now. Over here. Far left. Let's see if we have anything that anybody wants to keep.
I can't read them from here.
Hamp and Noho.
No.
A unique downtown.
No.
Open for business.
Yeah, okay.
Is that different than any place else? Is that different than Amherst?
Lots of small towns in this country.
Amherst is not open for business.
Open for business.
So should we keep this one or not keep it?
No.
Okay. Great public schools. That, I think, goes back to the informed community, intellectual, you know, all of that is connected, but that's a subset of that, you know, great public schools. So should we keep it or not? Okay. How about on this side? Yes, no?
Generic.
Yeah. Lexington and Brookline.
I keep it because there are a lot of towns that claim to be like this one where the middle class, if they can afford it, go to parochial or private schools. And there's much less of that here than.
Yeah, but if you compare it to Lexington, Brookline, Winchester, those are all top school systems that are public, and so I don't think it's that different. There are a lot of those in Massachusetts.
Okay.
Long Meadow has a good school system. I'm not sure Springfield is as good, but I think Long Meadow probably has a good one.
Sometimes we stand out as great public schools and not a rich community, because almost other examples of good public schools are rich communities.
Good point. Good point. I think
I would argue that you want to say something, because after all, there is a town fairly close to here where the state has taken over the schools. That's how bad they are.
Right.
Or perceived.
Right.
That's
all right, so let's leave this one in then. Great public schools, leave it in. Because it's not.
Well, would family friendly, or a lot of communities are family friendly, so I guess not.
A city with farms.
Yeah, that's a technique.
Okay. This one I don't quite understand. Arts Night Out.
That's what it's called.
Second Friday of
Okay.
Yes?
In SOA, south of Washington Street in the south end of Boston, they have First Friday. And First Friday of every month, galleries are open and they have performances and... Okay, so...
It's everywhere.
I think it's not unique. This one should be a smile to some people. More than a college town. But does that have any meaning beyond the first hit of it?
Yeah, I think it says, sure, there's an important academic institution in town, and very influential and so on, but it's not, that's not everything.
Is that positive, though?
Yeah.
Let me ask you, why'd you move here?
Grandchildren.
Okay.
But if the college should ask why they down need tomorrow, there'd still be a lot in Northampton that's highly valuable. We aren't dependent on the college being here.
Right. But is that different?
Okay, let's leave that one in with a star. Here's another phrase that was interesting. An incubator, I'm not sure that's spelled right, but it could be. And an inspiration. Incubator and inspiration. That's, we're getting toward the poetry, away from the prose with that. Well, should we keep that one in?
No.
How about historic sightseeing? Sightseeing.
That's all over me.
Yeah.
I was going to say, but some of those are rich communities, too.
Well, Kim left, so you lost your biggest defender.
Okay.
But it is important.
Historic is important.
I mean, if we're thinking in terms of signage and information, it's important.
Is the goal to come up with our tagline, or is the goal...
If it happens, I'm not pushing to do it. If it happens, it happens.
Oh, yeah. Is historic
already in there?
Yes, it is. But if we had something, historic foundations or something to suggest more. We already have historic, so let's take it out. I agree. There it is.
In the historic, the Underground Railroad was here and there were abolitionists. You know, if you're looking for there was Dwight Moody and Edwards Church. There were big religious revivals here. There's tons of stuff. And really, Northampton is very old. We were just in a place that they were homesteading in 1909. You know, you go out west, nothing's old. We're really old. Northampton is 1654.
Beautifully preserved wilderness. Yes, no, over here? Not a, okay.
No.
No. Now, I'm going to say this, but you're going to immediately say, let's take it off. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow, because generally that comes up in every one of these exercises. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
No.
Safe, open environment. I think that says a lot of different things. Well, circle that one. Calvin Coolidge Home. That wouldn't excite me if I were coming from Akron. I think we can take that one out.
It's part of history.
Yeah, he says history, yeah. But no more interesting than the Underground Railroad, which I think would be of interest. From canal boats to bicycles.
Yeah,
Anybody like that still? Nobody seems to like that one, okay. High-quality library. I think that that goes with the other informed and all those nice words that we were using before. A city on the river. Is that how people think of?
No,
I don't think so. Okay, let's do the colors again and see if we agree, or if we're going to take any out. Green, what color green? Dark, British Racing, lime, what kind of green?
Celtics.
Leafy green.
Yeah. Leafy green. Leaf green. Blue and gold. We'll be happy to do options in all these colors if you want to keep them. They're not that many, so it'll give you something to get rid of in a couple months when we get back to it. Blue and gold circle, please. Rainbow. Now, I'm going to tell you, rainbow is not an easy group of colors to work with in terms of making signage. It may be symbolic and empathetic and all that, but it's not very good to try to have a lot of colors and then some lettering on top of it.
I don't think that's a good reason for taking it out at this point.
I didn't say I was. I'm just explaining why it wasn't good.
It's a good challenge.
Okay, we'll try it. Okay. White will probably be the lettering color, so that's good.
85%.
And then brick red. Good. Okay. So now we're going to future. Was that the one on the bottom here?
Future. Yeah.
Oh. Okay. Can you read those? Because I can't.
Affordable housing.
Sorry. Yeah.
Is that something we want to conclude here? 40B. Do we want to say that? I don't think so. I don't, because that's mandated around the state. Affordable housing. The Commonwealth.
Isn't that something that you want to be proud of?
But it's not unique at all, and the mandate is for 10% in every community, and very few have it. But I don't know, what is the affordable housing?
12.3%.
That's very good. 12.3%. We can come back to that later if you really want that, but it's not the essence of the community that we're trying to reach here. What's the next line, please?
More frequent train service.
That's not the essence of the community. Right? I don't know why we were saying these things, what we thought we were.
Yeah.
Next one, it's healthy. I thought we were going for the future is what that was about. So I think maybe there's been some confusion.
Healthy, yeah.
Healthy is not bad. There's nothing bad there.
Circle. Historic signage.
Well, we're going to do that, so I don't think it has to be on the list.
Okay.
That's part of what we're about.
Temporary signs.
We're going to do that too, to test them.
So you want me to strike both of these? Public restrooms.
I'm not sure that's in our mandate to work on that.
I think that's fairly important. If you really want people to wander about and feel comfortable in the streets and so on, you've got to have some restrooms.
The next one is gender-inclusive public restrooms.
Yes. I would keep that rather than just restrooms.
Take out the top one then.
Not in Kansas anymore.
I like that. I suggest you have two red shoes to.
I don't want to diss Kansas, honestly.
All right, I think you're right. We should take it out.
We should take it out.
Good community policing.
Don't you already have that?
Yes.
have a question. If new words pop up as we're going through this exercise, do you want me to hold it or then wait until after you cross out ones before suggesting other ones?
Go ahead, suggest.
Sorry.
I don't want you to explode or anything during
the we didn't see green spaces. The phrases that have popped into my head is a living history of social justice learning in green spaces.
Can you be a little more succinct?
Well, living history, because we have Sojourner Truth and we have some of those values that are sort of moving forward into today. We've got social justice. I was thinking of Sojourner Truth for social justice and the left-leaning progressive words that we were throwing around. Learning, because we were struggling with Smith College and those words. And then green spaces, because I'm crazy about the fact that we've conserved farm space and conservation land inside of city limits, which I think is pretty unique that
we
have.
We've got the things you've mentioned. They're already
there. They're all up there. Okay, great.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I think so.
Let's go back to good community policing. I think that exists, right? I'm not...
Yeah, well, we want to keep it for the future.
Okay, so keep it for the future. I see what you're saying. Okay. And now the last group.
So these are
symbols.
Yeah, this one down here. Look at this.
That was future too.
I'm sorry, what is it?
I think that was future as well.
Do we want to do this one or do
let's finish that, you know, the one in your hand. Let's do that one.
Okay, so tolerant.
Do we like that word?
Yes. Vibrant and the best city all around.
I don't think tolerant is really a good word though.
I've always had a negative association with that word. It means like you'll put up with something versus like openness or acceptance, which I think are more positive.
Yeah, it's about separation. I mean, I'll accept it, but it's separated from me. Whereas openness is a much better word, I agree.
So I'll replace tolerant with openness?
Well, I think we have it, don't we?
I think it's up there in other areas.
Welcoming, friendly.
Inclusive.
Right. Inclusive is a much better word than tolerant.
Vibrant and the best city all around.
Take out best city all around.
Keep vibrant.
You already have vibrant on the first, the one page.
Yeah, vibrant.
Mm-hmm. So we should definitely use it then. It's on two.
Grandchildren's home.
Next one?
Grandchildren's home.
No.
Neighborly.
We had friendly and welcoming.
Yeah.
I don't know if we need neighborly.
Funky mix of old and new with things conserved and room for innovation.
That's too long.
I
tend to take all the
yes, I remember those. Growing.
That's vibrant.
Well, that's a point. Do we want our city to grow, or are we satisfied with its current size? Or would we be happier if it's a bit smaller?
Shrinking.
We haven't talked about that.
Does vibrant cover that?
I don't think you have to grow to be vibrant.
No, but I'm just...
Yeah, I mean, it's energetic. It's energy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think...
I think dynamic includes... growing, but I'm not sure that vibrant includes growing. You can be vibrant and be satisfied with that, but I don't know that it conveys growth.
Yeah, that's my question, really about the physical size. Would we be happier with a city of 50,000 rather than 30,000? Or would that be
too much?
I would make that
question. Strong disagreement.
What?
You never reach
consensus. No. It puts two stars by that one, and we'll move on, because we're not going to come up with a consensus on that tonight.
Leafy.
I think we got leaf green, so we've already got that, right?
Okay.
It's one of our...
Heritage for the future.
We have historic...
There's something good in that to me, heritage and future together. Keep that, and we'll see what we can work with that later. At the next meeting, which will probably be in 2 months, the public meeting, because we'll have a meeting of this group, and then we'll have another one to show you and wrestle with it some more.
Okay, next one is just.
Is that unique here? That's certainly aspirational.
Right, okay,
I'm just asking. All right, circle it for the time being.
Welcoming to refugees.
Well, we have welcoming already and friendly, so we don't need that, I don't think. Welcoming in a general sense.
Okay, the last two pages here are images. So it starts with bicycle.
Is that really unique?
Driving to town, one of the first things you see is a bicycle image showing you where the bike paths are.
Yeah.
I think that's dynamic.
Okay, all right, circle it.
Mills.
No. I'd say no.
No?
No. No.
Okay.
There are a lot of mill towns around here.
Leaves.
Yeah.
Did you say leaves?
Leaves, yes.
Yeah.
And Gothic towers on City Hall.
Very unique.
Yes?
Sure.
Yes. Trees.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes?
Everything, yeah.
Sojourner Truth Image.
Yes.
Leave that, yeah.
David Ruggles.
Oh, the two go together, yeah.
Oh, they go together?
Ruggles and Underground.
He was an abolitionist, right?
Okay. All right, so David Ruggles and the Underground Railroad, we're leaving this. Farm animals.
No.
Chickens. Rainbow flag.
Again, there's a problem of the graphic and working with it. But leave it, I mean.
But that may be an important thing to struggle with.
Okay.
Leave it
in. People moving, running, walking.
I think that's important. That's a constant. There's always people walking and moving around the downtown. It's vibrant.
Yeah.
It's all a part of that.
Leave that.
Looking for graphic images? Is that what are you looking for?
A symbol of the community.
A symbol. Okay. So, yes, we leave that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the Oxbow?
No.
No? Downtown / streetscape.
We like that?
Yeah.
Yes, no?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, leave that.
All right, and spires?
Spires is a problem. Why? Because generally you want to separate church and state. And generally, we do not have, there are a lot of communities that have a lot of church spires in them. And it's not something that necessarily is, it may be architecturally significant, but it's not
that
unique, right?
Park of the River.
Now, that might have some abstract graphic quality to it, so we should look at that.
Holyoke Range?
I'm not sure what that means.
Just the mountains you look at.
Just the mountains.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes? Bears?
Do you know that the city of Berlin is named after a bear? Berlin is the bear town. Just a little... A little history lesson, like. Next.
Famous Americans?
No.
No.
And Coyote?
No. No. Okay. You've done wonderfully well. If I could get this other one. Whoop. Next steps. We're ready to say goodnight after these. Develop brand image. Thank you so much. Applause. Next steps. Develop a brand image designs based upon ideas that we've been talking about. and create options, so that it's not just one thing, but there's several to look at. Apply the brand concepts to wayfinding elements. Publish and have public review, that is, we'll put it out in social media, newspaper, whatever. And work up options for a slogan or tagline, if they seem to be going in that direction. We might want to work on that together in 2 months. And publish and have public input into everything that we've done, so that people feel ownership here. Even if you put up something and it was taken away, you still feel ownership, because at least you express yourself, right? And I've found that this is true in the other 17 times I've done this in the last couple of years, that the community feels ownership, and that's what's important. It's not my ideas, it's your ideas. I help interpret them and translate them visually. So thank you all for coming and staying so long.
Do you have the date in 2 months?
No, we haven't said that. So the committee has a working date. They'll be meeting at 10 a.m. Tuesday, October 11th. It's certainly public, but it's not a public forum. And then they'll be setting up a date in November for the next forum after that. But we'll get the word out the same way we got the word out this one.
So thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.